My name is Trevor, and today I'll be doing a review on the Mobile Operation Center. As you can see here, this is my Mobile Operation Center. I've chose the Phantom Custom for the cab, and this is my trailer. So to be able to purchase this MOC, which is the Mobile Operation Center, as you can see right here, you have to purchase a bunker from the Maze Bank Foreclosures website first, which is over here. And then you can purchase the Mobile Operation Center from Warstock, as you can see here. The Mobile Operation Center can be purchased from Warstock for more than a million. I think it's 1.2 million if I'm not wrong. And if you want to change if you have bought the Mobile Operation Center already, like me, and if I would want to change the cab, like right now I have the Phantom Custom, as you can see. If I want to change it to the Hauler Custom, I will have to pay the full price of the whole MOC, which is 1.4 million, as you can see. Just now I said it wrong. It's 1.4 million in total. But I would stick with the Phantom Custom because I like it. And that's the cap done. So we'll first go. I'll show you Bay 1. So this Bay 1, the command center, where there is the computer for doing mobile operation vehicle missions. And there's also TVs and cameras that you can use to see the turrets from the front and the back of the MOC. So other than that, I also have the living quarters. As you can see here, the living quarters, I recommend not to buy it because it's quite useless actually. Because all it has is a computer and some chairs for you to sit down, and that's all. So I will not buy the living quarters. Okay, Bay 1 is done, so let's hit Bay 2. As you can see here, I have already put the weapon and vehicle workshop combination for Bay 2 and Bay 3, because this bay specifically, the weapon and vehicle workshop bay, needs 2 spaces. And I recommend that you buy the weapon and vehicle workshop because here is where you can modify your weaponized vehicles, as you can see here. And you can also modify your weapons and make them Mark 2. So other than that, there is an empty bay, which is before you buy any. Sorry about that, it's my phone. Okay, anyway, where was I? Before you buy anything, you will be default bay, it will be empty. So you will have to select either the living quarters weapon workshop or weapon and vehicle workshop. I recommend that you buy the weapon and vehicle workshop because here is where you can modify your weaponized vehicles, and as you saw just now, it warned me that it uses 2 bays, Bay 2 and Bay 3. So if I already used the Bay 3 for the weapon and vehicle workshop, I can't get another bay here. So if I don't get the vehicle and weapon workshop, I'm going to show you right now. Let me put an empty bay for now, and I'll choose Bay 3. I can choose the living quarters, which is just now I told you is not. I recommend not to buy it because it's quite useless. So other than that, there's a weapon workshop, which is the same as you saw in the weapon and vehicle workshop. It's just a bigger area for weapons. And the personal vehicle storage here as well, if you want to store personal vehicles. But for me, I don't want to have that, so I will stick with the weapon and vehicle workshop because I want to customize my vehicles. And remember, the bay is double size, so you can't buy any other bay in Bay 3 if you have the weapon and vehicle workshop. And the weapon and vehicle workshop only works for weaponized vehicles that came with the Gunrunning DLC. You can't just steal a car from the street and bring it inside to modify it. So that won't work. And okay, next is the interior color. Here is where you can select the color for your MOC. For me here, I have chosen the primary color gray and the secondary color gray as well, because I kind of like how it looks like. But if you want, you can also change the color of it. So you can see right here, but for me, I'm not going to change it because I'm not buying it. I don't want to renovate it because I already like mine. Then you can modify your mobile operation center, like the looks and the cab and the trailer, from your bunker. As you can see right here, you just have to walk up to this mechanic right here, and you can press E to access the bunker vehicle workshop, as you can see on the top left just now, like right now. Okay, so I'm going to press E, and here is where you can modify your mobile operation center and your anti-aircraft trailer. But for this video, I'm going to show you how to customize the mobile operation center, and I'm also going to show you the customization options. So here you can see I've clicked the mobile operation center tab, and here's where you can customize the cab and the trailer for your mobile operation center. So I'm going to show you some of the stuff. Here is the armor. and sometimes on the cap, some of the stuff might, like the modifications might get reset to the stock one. As you can see right here, I used to have 100% armor on this cap, but it has went to none. It's a bug with this with Gunrunning, where the mobile operation center cap will reset back to stock. But other than that, I'm gonna show you some of the modifications. There's brakes, there's engine, the horn. There's different horns as well, cop horn, cow horn, and other horns. Headlights, xenon lights, and stock lights. I used to have xenon lights, but as usual, I told you it got reset because of the glitch from Gunrunning. So other than that, the plate, I can show you the plate right here. There are different plates. Okay, next is respray. I'm going to show you the colors that are available for you to purchase. So I'm going to go through them right now, like this. There are a lot of colors available, so I'm just going to scroll through them so that you can see it briefly. If not, it'll be quite a long video because I don't want to speak for so long about all the colors. So that's what you saw, and my crew color is orange because I'm in a different crew for now. And that's the okay. I'm going to show you the matte one because I didn't show you just now. So this is how it looks like matte, and there's only 20 colors compared to 75 like in the classic one. So other than that, that's the primary color. The suspension, you can as you can see, it will go down up. So that's the suspension. The transmission is just for the acceleration, so I'm not going to show that. Turbo as well. Wheels. There's bulletproof tires. Oh, that one didn't get reset. Okay, that's good. Tire smoke, and here's our tire smoke. I can't really show you because I kept the stock tire smoke, and I can't show you the smoke when it's not moving. So I'm not going to show you that. The windows, light smoke, dark smoke, and limo. So that's all for the cab. I'm going to show the trailer now. There is going to be liveries in the future, like Independence Day. I believe there's going to be some Independence Day liveries for the trailer, if I'm not wrong. So that's the liveries because there's none. And here are the plates that you can select, the different type of plates and respray options. I'm going to go through all of them like this so that you can see briefly how it looks like with different colors. Okay, that's primary color, and now I'm going to show the secondary color, which is the top ring of the MOC. As you can see, it's changing color. That's the secondary color. So that is the secondary color. And weapons, for the weapons, the front turret, which is this one, is quite hard to see because my mobile operation center is black and white. But this part is the front turret, which comes stock with the mobile operation center. But if you can unlock the rear turret, as you can see here, but by doing research in your bunker, you can unlock it from doing research in your bunker, and then you need to purchase it from here. I already purchased that because I already unlocked it via research. So that's all for the outside of the mobile operation center. I'm going to show you the inside of the mobile operation center which I bought. So how you get in is from the back. There's going to be a blue circle that you can enter from. Okay, as you can see, I am now inside of the mobile operation center. This is the bay 2 and bay 3, which is the weapons and vehicle workshop that I showed you just now. So I will show you how you can customize your vehicles in a bit. So this is how it looks like. It's quite a big area because it's two bays. And this is the mechanic you saw outside when you customize the cap and trailer. And here is the weapons and vehicle workshop, in fact, where you can customize Mark 2 weapons. As you can see, some of my weapons are really customized. The only weapon I do not have is SMG because I don't want to modify that. But as you can see, my other weapons have been modified quite nicely. And yeah, that's the weapons. I'm not going to show you too much of that. But let me give you a warning. Do not buy the gun locker in the bunker. You know why? It's because the MOC comes with a weapon loadout or weapon locker if you buy the weapon workshop or the weapon and vehicle workshop combination. So it comes with a weapon locker, so do not buy the locker in the bunker because that's how I found out. So I just wasted money on the bunker. And here I'm gonna go through this sliding door. This is the command center as I showed you just now. And this part, if you can see, there's a hanger logo. It's for you to change clothes. I can change outfits right here. There's a lot of outfits that I can change from because I have a lot of outfits. So anyway, this is the command center. I'm going to show you the turrets later, because now I'm inside the bunker. So this is how it looks like. I have modified it to be gray, primary and secondary color. And this, as you saw just now, is the mobile operation vehicle mission touchscreen computer. And this computer you can use only if you are registered as a VIP CEO or motorcycle club president. So I'm going to register as a CEO right now. Okay, I've done that. And now I can press E, and then I can access this touchscreen computer where I can do the vehicle missions to unlock the trade price for some of the vehicles. If you don't get what I mean, it's like if I complete severe weather patterns, it means I can unlock the trade price, which is discounted. So I can get a discount price for the dune buggy, as you can see here. So that's what all these vehicle missions are for, is for you to get trade prices. So that's all for the inside. Later I'll show you, when I drive this out of the bunker, I'll show you how it looks like outside. So now I'm going to exit the trailer. So as you can see, my mobile operation center is right here. So I'm going to get inside. This is how you drive it out of your bunker. Basically, you just have to get into the cab and press forward or backward, which is W and S on the PC. It's just like exiting and entering your garage. So anyway, we're now outside of the bunker in the mobile operation center. So I'm going to show you how you can use the rear turrets and the front turrets. So basically, you just have to run to the back, as I showed you just now. And there will be a blue corner, like this dot, the blue corner, which is the dot. Anytime you stop the MOC, the blue corner will spawn on the behind the trailer. So now I'm going to run to the turrets, as you can see. As you can see, there's one chair right here. This is for the front turrets, that's why it's alone at one side. And these two seats right here, as you can see, I'm pointing to it, towards it. It's the rear turrets, because there's two rear turrets and one front turret. So I'm going to show you the rear turrets first. So I'm going to sit down. I'm going to press enter to use the turret. As you can see, press enter to use the mobile operation center turret. And press E to stand up. But I'm not going to stand up just yet, because I'm going to show you how it looks like. So as you can see, this is the rear turret from where I parked my MOC just now. That is my bunker right there. And this camera, you can actually zoom in quite far. And you can also turn right and left very far. But it's there's not much space you can turn left and right on the front turret, because it's different. So as you can see, this is the maximum I can turn to the right. And I'm going to turn to the left right now. Okay, this is the maximum you can turn to the left. And inside of the tower, the most important thing is that you can fire it. As you can see, it shoots quite fast. Not that bad for turret like that. And it can also shoot quite far. I think it can shoot there. I wonder if I can shoot there. Yep, it can even reach that far. So I'm going to exit of this turret. I believe this is one of the turrets from the back. It's either the left or the right. I can't really remember. But anyway, that's for the back turrets. I'm not going to show the other back turret, because it's exactly the same. So I'm going to head to the front turret right now, which is over here. So I'm going to sit down. Press E to sit down on PC. So I'm going to press enter as usual, as you saw just now. Press enter. And now this is the front turret. As you can see on the bottom of the screen is the truck cab. And I don't know what's going on there. It looks like there's an accident. And I'm going to show you how powerful this is. One shot and you can destroy one car already. Which is how powerful this turret is. But as you can see, I can't really turn that much to the left on the front. And I can't really turn that much to the right as well, because this is the front turret. I don't know what's with that. But anyway, that's for the turrets. Now I'm going to exit of the MOC. And I'm going to drive it. I'm going to show you how you can modify some of your weaponized vehicles. And if you didn't know, there are two exit places in the MOC. One at the front here, the command center, you can exit the trailer. Or you can go to the back and exit from the back, which is right here. So for now, I'm going to exit from the back. And then I'm going to drive my weaponized vehicle inside, which is right here. This is my half track. I'll be doing a review on this quite soon. So as you can see, I have entered the half track, which is my personal weaponized vehicle. So I'm going to drive it to the back of the MOC right here, like this. So once you reach here, you're going to press E to modify it. And there's a nice cutscene that you can see when you enter the MOC. And here, as you can see, I'm modifying the half track now, which is this truck. It looks exactly like LSE, the categories that you can modify from. So I'm not going to show you the modification because that's the half track and not the truck. So this is how it looks like. It's just like LSE. You can put liveries, you can put proximity mines, modifications. You can also choose respray like that. Or you can also sell it, you can put turbo, you can put weapons as well, right here. And then you can also select window. So that's all for the vehicle customization. I'm not going to show you any more of that, but I'm going to exit the MOC in half track. And then, wait, let me get closer to the MOC first. So if you didn't know, you can even detach the trailer in the MOC by pressing H, which is the headlight option. So I'm going to hold H down. As you can see, the trailer has been detached. And I can attach it by reversing into it like that. As you can see now, I have attached it. So I'm going to show you how I'm going to drive around in this. It's quite a fast vehicle, considering how heavy the trailer is. So I'm going to drive around in it. Show you some cinematic views of it. So this truck is very big. It's sometimes on the road, if you are making a sharp turn, it can be quite hard to turn. But even if you detach the trailer, you can still enter the back. As you can see now, I'm moving the truck, so there's no blue corner at the back of the truck. So I'm going to stop it right now. As you can see, there's a blue dot that just popped up behind the trailer. That's the blue corner which you can use to enter the MOC. So I'm gonna move off, and you can see that the blue dot has just disappeared because I'm moving and I can't enter while I'm moving. So even if I stop the trailer like this, and if I detach the trailer, you can still enter the MOC by, even if it's not being pulled, like right now I can still enter it even though there's no truck pulling it. But I'm not going to enter it again. As you can see, that's the rear turret right there. If you didn't see just now, that's the rear turret. And it seems like there's a Hydra coming for me, so I'm just going to go into passive, because I don't want to be disturbed while making this video. So anyway, I'm going to attach it again. As you can see, there's a front turret. That's the front turret right there. It's pointing to right because that's where I left it. It seems like that's a Hydra coming for me. It's a good thing. Oh, am I even in passive? Oh, I can't even go in passive while in the MOC. Okay, that's fine. But anyway, I'm going to drive back to the bunker actually in this MOC. Okay, this could be a bit hard, because it's quite a big vehicle, as I told you just now. So it can be quite hard to reverse it. So now I'm going to drive back to my bunker so that it's much safer. And I already show you some of the things of the MOC, like the speed and how you can modify it, and the base inside and how much it costs. So I'm going to drive it into my bunker right now. I'm on the way to my bunker. So if you guys don't know Takumi Fujiwara, as you see in the chat right there, it's basically one of the Japanese, no, I can't remember if it's Japanese or Korean, I can't remember, because I didn't watch Initial D for a while. Takumi Fujiwara is basically a character from Initial D, and it's also one of my friend's nicknames, because he likes Initial D. So that's my friend nickname right there, Takumi Fujiwara is my friend. So now I'm going to drive this inside the bunker. As you can see, this beautiful cutscene of the MOC going inside. So I don't even have to press anything, like now I don't have to hold W or anything, because it's just a cutscene. So I'm gonna wait for it to load, as it takes a while, sometimes it takes a while. So it seems like it's taking a while to load, so I'm just gonna wait here. Okay, finished loading. As you can see, the cutscene of me driving into the bunker. I do not have to control anything right now because it's still a cutscene. So I'm gonna exit of the mock right now, like that. And that's all for the mobile operation center. So this is how it looks like from the outside. And I think that's all for the mobile operation center. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Do like and subscribe if you enjoyed it. Remember to leave a thumbs up and comment if you want to suggest any videos I should make in the future. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out!